Hello traders, FX Pip Collector here. Today is Monday, July 31st, and I'm going to be analyzing the Aussie dollar, starting on the monthly, working my way down to the 1 hour time frame. So on the Aussie dollar monthly, I still think this is most likely three ways up for the W. It looks like three ways down for an X. I still believe there's a very good likelihood this is going to make three ways up for a wave Y, which should take out these highs and end up looking something along these lines. So let's head down to the weekly time frame. On the weekly time frame, I still think this right here is higher highs, higher lows. Looks to be like a wave one of Y. This definitely looks like a three-way pattern, like a crescent, like a two of Y. I still think there's a very good chance this is going to end the crescent. It's going to continue up and eventually make a wave three, four, and five of what should be a wave Y, like I was showing you on the higher time frames. So let's take it down to the daily time frame. On the daily time frame, I still believe that this impulsive move up is a 1. I think this move down is already a crescent. I was actually originally thinking that the crescent was over, which I still think it possibly is over right here, and that this is like a 1 of 3, and this is like an ABC, like a 2 of 3. We are making a bounce at a fib level, so we had to pay attention on the sort of time frames to see if we can figure out if that really is the end of a crescent. If it is the end of a crescent, then it will keep on trending up, because that would be a wave 3, and a wave 3 should be the biggest, strongest wave of a trend. So let's take it down to the 4-hour time frame. On the 4-hour time frame, it definitely looks like a trend right here, like an A. It looks like three ways up for a B, and it looks like a downtrend for a C. We definitely made a nice fib bounce right here. But looking at the dollar index, I do have a little bit of doubts about this really being the end of an ABC crescent. If it is the end of an ABC crescent, this will just keep on trending up very impulsively, making higher highs, higher lows. If it's not the end of a crescent, then we'll see three waves up, impulsive down, and we'll see price continue the downtrend, which will be easier to see on the 1 hour time frame. So going down to the 1 hour time frame, this first move up is either a wave 1 or a wave A. This move down is either a wave 2 or a wave B. This current move up that we're currently seeing is either a wave C, which a wave C may look like this, may make an impulsive move down with a break of structure. So if we see that impulsive down with a break of structure, we'll know we're looking at a wave C and we can go short for the continuation of the downtrend. On the other hand, if price keeps making higher highs, higher lows, and never breaks structure to the downside, then we'll know it's a wave 3, and we can just keep on going long at the end of every pullback we see for the continuation of that wave 3. So don't forget to join my free Discord channel. The link for that is on the screen and in the description. Thanks, and happy trading.